Michael Wolfhackel from the Danish Culture Institute. How do you define citizenship in the 21st century?
I define citizenship in the 21st century, I think you can define it in two ways. In one way, it's the same as it's always been. I mean, you're always able to talk about citizenship, whether it's 2,000 years ago or today. But whereas yesterday it was something which was, I don't know, maybe harder to enact on a global scale, today with internet and the possibilities of global networks, you have a completely different way of enacting citizenship. And I think if you should define it today, then it has something to do with trying to make a global impact, or at least the most major impact that you can using the means that you have. I think that's how I would define it, I guess. It's a big question.
So you're saying people should work in groups, small or large groups, to try and change society, the way we live?
Well, you know, of course, it's always the problem about giving answers, or simple answers, is that you can say, well, then what if you want to spread something bad? Couldn't you say the same thing? Yes, you could. So how do you, and obviously I would say that I want to spread something good. So how do you define something good? Well, you know, if that's the starting point, then you'll always have a problem, because you can always argue, well, cars, as we're advocating environmentally friendly vehicles, cars, well, cars are not really a good thing. You should bike, or you should walk, or you should take the bus. All right, well, people are actually using cars, and we think people will continue to do so. So our message is trying to spread awareness of environmentally friendly vehicles that you can actually drive and not harm the environment. And to do that, you have to up the stake. It just doesn't work today if you think, well, I just want to change what's going on in Copenhagen, because Copenhagen is a part of a global network. So you might as well put on the big glasses and say, well, okay, so if I want to do it worldwide, that's ridiculous, but if I want to, what do I do? Well, it's not a ridiculous question when you start thinking about it and start thinking about, well, this would be, if I could get this global message out, something could happen. Well, today you can actually get a global message out. You can reach countries that you've never been to, but it has to start somewhere, and there's only one place where it can start, and that's you.
So you have an idea. Do you then see that the internet, the social media, are the most suitable channel for getting that idea out to other people so you can work together?
Well, the internet is just one out of a string of means you have. For instance, for us, we use the internet, but up until now, we've mostly used it for information gathering, networking, and communicating with people all over the world. But we haven't really used it that much in terms of marketing our project. We have a website, but it's not a fancy website, and we don't really use internet much in terms of marketing. What we've done is we've created an event which is very physical and live. You see a convoy in the street. So it's sort of the opposite of the internet, which is virtual. But so to answer your question, I see internet as one of the marketing means that you should use. And I will also say, and I think you should combine it with something else, it's when you have the combination of in real life and a virtual life that you can really make something big. Whether it goes one way or the other isn't important, but there has to be an interplay. And what I'm really looking forward to is when we start working more intensively on our web efforts, how well and you know, how much better we'll be able to spread our message, because we haven't really used it that much up until now, so it'll be interesting.
You imply that the social media, or rather the networks, the type of thing you're talking about, can be used in positive and negative directions. What do you think is the biggest challenge facing citizenship?
I guess that's what we're gathered for here today to discuss as well. And still, after a day of discussions, I'm perhaps even more, confused. But I think that's probably also one of the key points about this question. You have to realize there's no easy answer. I mean, you can't have a quick reply that'll answer. Okay, so this is it, and that's a good thing, because it also says to you, well, you have to look at yourself as well. When you pose this question, you have to give it the respect it deserves, and that includes giving yourself the respect you deserve. In my case, for instance, I worked as a lawyer, and on paper this was all fine, and it was safe, and it was respected, but I didn't enjoy it myself. I was still a citizen, but I feel more of an active citizen now, way more than I did back then. And so if I have anything to spread from what I've learned, it is you've got to take a good, deep look at yourself and say, is this really what I want to contribute with? Is this what I want to be my legacy? And be honest and be bold, take chances, and more than anything, be honest.
So you have to be deeply engaged for whatever subject you're going to get involved in. Use your own talents.
I think we all know the answers to be honest. I mean, once we really pose those questions, it's not, I think when we choose the easy way out, like when I chose to be a prison lawyer instead of working with something I really love, I knew the answers, and I also had an idea what the right answer was, but I didn't think it was capable of it, or I was too afraid to take the jump. I'll do it tomorrow. I had all sorts of excuses, and it wasn't until I said to myself, well, listen, if you can't, when you're on top of the world, it came to me at Burning Man, actually, where I finally made the decision, when you're on top of the world and you can say, I'm the king of the world, I can do whatever I want, I have all these amazing ideas and meeting creative people and let's do something about it. Well, that's it. I mean, if you think when you're living it out in your head that that's it, it's not. You have to enact it in real life. You have to go from thought to action. And if all your thoughts are never, being put into action, what are they worth? I mean, don't kid yourself, don't kid me, because I know if it's just stuff, I could do this, I could do whatever, but you're not. No, but I could. I don't care. I mean, cool, fine, good for you, but not good for me, not good for anyone else. It's like someone said to me that a definition of science is, it's not science if it hasn't been publicized. And at first I was a little reluctant to that. It's still science if you make a really good report and then, you've done put a lot of work in it. Of course it's science, but I see the point. If it's not something that's coming out and people actually have a chance of learning from it, it's just your own work. It's the same with art. If it's not something you go out and spread, it's just your own. And there's nothing wrong with that. But don't make it as good as what is actually out there, because, for better or worse, it means something. Much more than just a fancy idea of how you want to save the world.
One last question. With your background as a lawyer, with your enthusiasm for this project you have of electric vehicles, do you not feel your next project should be promoting citizenship?
Well, I guess I hope, I hadn't thought about it before Asif asked me to come here, and then after a while it sort of struck me that I guess that is what I'm doing. The next project we have will certainly promote citizenship as well. I hope in its own abstract way this project also promotes citizenship. I certainly see it as doing that. But you're right. I mean, I'm sure that the work and the connection we have with Asif will continue, and he's an ideas man himself, so he'll most likely come up with good ideas of combining forces and spreading the message. So, yeah, it's probably already in the cards.
Michael Wolfheck, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
This is Michael Zelen for the Copenhagen Voice.